And we're back. Irv Brown, Chris Dickerson, world's best bodybuilders, getting ready backstage. There's a future bodybuilder, Chris. He looks like he's ready to go.
Probably. He's there anyway.
Light heavyweight competition coming up, and we'll pick it up in Barbados with Patrick Nichols. How big is the sport in Barbados, Chris?
Very big in Barbados. I was there recently. And these men, some of them know very little about diets, but they just have it genetically. You know what I mean, Irv? Work hard, and they turn out tremendous champions. This routine's a bit slow for me. We'll see if it livens it up a bit. Big man.
He is big, a lot of mass here. Chris, a question if I may. You're talking about diet. What do you have to eliminate to get yourself ready?
Well, to look like this man in this pose, you cut out sugar, fats, all dairy products. Avoid the salt. That makes you retain water. Some emphasis on protein. Good carbohydrates. Low calories.
Chris, Patrick does not have good calf development. Is this going to really hurt him?
It will, especially being a fairly tall man. Shows up more.
You've talked about this before, but I think it's worth repeating. How can you build your calves? Is there another exercise that we haven't talked about?
Well, calf raises are the traditional exercises, one way or the other. I personally prefer calf raises upside down on what we call the leg press machine for 25 to 30 repetitions.
Patrick Nichols from Barbados.
A bit unimaginative, I would say, not to be overly critical. He's better than his routine. I don't think he showed his body to advantage.
Representing the United States of America, Phil Williams. We've had a chance to see Phil several times.
Yes, I've worked with Phil a bit in the coaching. And he's very, very good. He's very impressive. Has an awesome back. One of the best backs you'll ever see anywhere. Has his own style.
Have some mass.
Very good choice of music here. Brings the audience in with it.
It's gonna be tough to beat.
A lot of beef. It's interesting how this man shows much more style, much more confidence in all of it than the preceding man. This is what the judges want to see. Bill Williams of the United States.
It's a great pose for him.
Very slow, deliberate movements. It's a very reaching routine, very imaginative. It just draws you into it.
Chris, it's a long routine.
It is.
Does this help or hurt you?
It helps if you hold the audience. This man is. time invariably the worst poser will pose the longest. Fortunately, that isn't happening today.
So what you're saying, this is not turning into an irritant. If he was a bad poser and didn't have muscularity, it would become an irritant.
Absolutely. You want him off. An outstanding back, if ever there was one.
Look at that move.
Huh. Wow.
Ready to strike, huh? Like a cobra.
That's the feeling you get from him. Very powerful.
This is Phil Williams using all of Lionel Richie's songs. I was clean shaven when I came here, Chris. Good routine. Any restrictions as far as length of time, length of music?
In some amateur contests, they do restrict you. In the professional contests, you have no restriction at all. I myself have posed for as long as 4.5 minutes. Now, that's pretty long to pose. As an amateur, we were restricted to 90 seconds, sometimes even 60 seconds some years ago. The average pose routine today is about 2 minutes. Look at the cat. Phil's got it all. There's the crab. Now he can do the crab. I don't mind it on him. On some bodybuilders, I don't care for the crab. He's so impressive. He's got so much density, so much depth to his body that you want to see it on him.
And what's interesting, because it has been a very long routine that's finally over, the crowd did not get bored.
No. They loved it.
They're still applauding and appreciating.
I think they want more.
Bill Williams. Up next from the Netherlands is Arnold Berman. What do we know about the Netherlands as far as competition, the coaching?
They don't have a lot of competitors in international meets, but they are very good. They're a strong country for physique contests.
Immediately went to the back. Is there a message there?
Well, I like the movement. He's showing front, back, he's using his legs. That's a good way to hold the audience. Don't just stand there facing front all the time. Three-quarter side pose. Different positions. Music change here. Impressive leg development. Join the calf.
He's pointing to that calf.
Yeah, he wants us to see it for sure.
Chris, with as strong a back as Williams showed us, Berman follows up and starts out with the back. What's the judge thinking about? Because this has been more impressive than the back, in my opinion.
Well, you see, he's worked his routine out already, Arnold has, and you can't suddenly change your pose routine just there on the spot. You've got to do what you practice. It's always better to stick to your game plan. They won't hold it against him. They're going to see it eventually anyway. Now, it'd be silly for him to stand up next to Williams and do a back pose. And I'm sure he wouldn't.
He is impressive. Netherlands are doing all right. Arnold Berman is doing all right.
Really showing those legs. That is a strong feature, wouldn't you say?
Oh, yeah.
Definitely, the legs.
Arnold Berman. There's some competition there. All right, up next, from Germany, Josef Gromulus. We saw him in Las Vegas. You talk about massive. He still
this
has it.
This man is ready today. Very impressive physique.
Look at the serious note.
Dramatic style. This man is so cut up, so defined, and so hard. Side bicep, all of it.
Guy shows you some personality. What is Williams thinking right now?
He's thinking this man's going to be tough to beat. And he is.
He looks better than he did in Las Vegas.
100% better. Thicker and more defined.
He was second a year ago, but he lost to one of the young up-and-coming stars of the sport, Rich Gaspari.
Yes, Gaspari just pulled ahead of him in the finals that evening. This man has quite a body.
Chris, is there an advantage here for Gromulus coming on after Williams? Is it pressure in the judge's mind?
Well, I always like to come on towards the end. I like to follow the rougher competitor because they remember you.
So there is a slight advantage.
I think there is. Nobody likes to be first.
Gromulus, outstanding. Look at the physique. Up next from Turkey is Ahmet Unlu.
Now, this is one of the best physiques. He's very symmetrical and very much in proportion. And here again, a veteran who's been around for a good 20 years.
Now you can weigh up to 198 pounds in light heavyweight competition.
Hit his poses a bit longer and keeping up to the beat of the music. He shouldn't have to. He's rushing the poses. You don't do yourself justice always doing that. Maybe he'll slow down later here. Let's see.
Turkey. You made a very good point, Chris. He really did not hold those poses. The judges didn't get a chance to assess his ability.
Just got on and off.
All right, once again from Czechoslovakia, Libor Minarek. Veins in his forehead.
And the more he flexes, the bigger they get.
Oh, there's no messing around with Libor, is there?
He's hard, and he's ready, and he's mad.
I'm kind of impressed what they're doing with the sport in Czechoslovakia. Jastrzebski impressed me, and there's nothing wrong with Mineric.
They're really coming up in Czechoslovakia. He has a dynamic posing style. He hits the poses real hard. Following the music, following the tempo. Good choice.
It's almost like he's powerlifting the way he throws himself into the pose.
Very powerful, yes.
All right, Libor Minarek coming up. We've got the compulsory and the pose down with Nichols, Williams, Berman. They'll all be here right after this message. Well, it's time for the compulsories and then the pose down. The crowd, you know what they're buzzing about.
Oh, there's two men out there that are really outstanding. It's going to be a pose down right to the finish, in my opinion, between Phil Williams and this man from Germany, Josef Gromulus.
And the voice you're hearing is Chris Dickerson, who has won this contest. I'm Irv Brown. We're delighted to be with you, bringing you the competition. This is light heavyweight compulsory.
Side chest pose. They're repeating the compulsors here.
Interesting, four of the competitors went with the right bicep and two went with the left.
Some like to show their best side, what they think is their best side. Now, Williams and Gromulus both wearing black trunks. There's a man between them, but compare these for yourself to see who you like. There's Williams. Wearing black trunks there.
Phil Williams from the United States. Next to Patrick Nichols from Barbados.
Remember, the back is Phil's best body part. This should be interesting. Here's Phil's back. Now watch Gromulus here. Black trunks. There's Gromulus. Who would you pick on that one? Pick Phil for that.
Chris, you had a chance to work with Williams. Will he jump up next to Gromulus during the pose down, or will he stay away?
I would say he will, if I had to guess.
Menard.
Even though Phil's a conservative man by nature, I think when he gets to these contests, he wants to compete.
Abdominals and thigh. Use two hands, please.
Phil's thighs. Now let's see Gromulus here. Incredible. He's different.
Thank you. Relax.
Pose down coming up.
Now comes the fight for the finish.
Pose down.
Now let's see if they get next to each other.
Uh-huh.
There he goes. Upstaging a little bit, Chris?
Yeah. Here's what happens.
Look, it looked like Gromulus a little bit upset there.
Little bit, that's the nature of the sport. Here they go again, Chris, in front of him. Here's Gromulus. No, that's the new little from Turkey. Where is Gromulus?
Well, we don't mean to,
I think Gromulus chose to get out of Phil's way and just clear the field, would you say, Irv?
Oh yeah, don't mean to be ignoring the other four, because obviously our opinions mean nothing to them. It just would seem that the competition is between Williams and Gromulus. All right, the decision is coming up. We'll have it for you on ESPN right after this message. Well, we're ready for the light heavyweight winner. A year ago, the winner was Rich Gaspari. Josef Gromulus in the competition tonight was number two.
Number six, Petrovac. Six. Ahmet Enunlu, Turkey. Turkey.
Place the match in Turkey.
Kind of seems pretty pleased. All kinds of competition. They're not, as I know, he gets a little kid. They're not just six competitors. They've been competing all day.
Patrick Nichols, Barbados.
All right, so Nichols has survived, and he is good. Gets the handshake. Some of the crowd did not agree with that. Patrick Nichols finishes fifth.
He's,
if you're
pretty
wondering,
happy with that decision,
sure,
I think.
There's Ben Weider. A year ago, Mark Bullock from Canada finished fifth in the competition in Las Vegas. We are in Goteburg, Sweden. All right, ready for number four.
Number four. Arnold Boomer, Netherlands.
Next reaction for the Netherlands is Arnold Berman finishes fourth
place. Can you feel the tension between Williams and the man from Germany?
Gromulus, definitely.
Gromulus.
Once again, Czechoslovakia is still alive, though, Chris. Libor Mynarek.
That's true.
Along with Williams and Gromulus. All right, there's Cottonmouth as they visit.
Third and winner of the bronze medal, Libor Mynarek, Czechoslovakia.
All right, no real surprise, I guess. The bronze medal goes to Czechoslovakia's Libor Mynarek.
Now comes the moment of truth. Who would you pick, Irv?
See, I'd pick Phil Williams, but I don't want to be deported.
Both men are very good, and good in different places. That's the problem, judging two men like them. They have different physiques. They're both big, but different.
Second and winner of the silver medal, Phil Williams.
Yes, sir. There's our winner, Gromulus, who was second a year ago to Rich Gaspari. Phil Williams of the United States wins the silver medal.
You know, this is the second first place, second gold medal for Germany so far.
Josef Gromulus does look good. He is the winner.
Happy man.
Mr. Universe, light heavyweight category. And he joins Herman Hoffman and Lee Labrada. All right, coming up, the heavy artillery, the heavyweights, right after this message on ESPN.